Today, we automate our smartphones and tablets. To build our machine, I'm sorry, but we will first need to do a bit of analysis. We will need to determine, first, the different clicking zones, as this will impact the design of our machine. We also need to understand the timing of each steps, as it will indicate the type of motor we need. In our case, we will need to get a motor that runs at maximum at 1 turn per 30 seconds or 2 RPM. For the motor, I will be reusing one located inside an old lamp, where the motor is used to rotate some optic fibers and create some amazing lighting effects. Since the motor is low speed, it should be a good match to what I'm looking for. Note that since I still use this lamp for other purposes, I will not desolder the motor, but only loan it by simply taking it out of its box without cutting any wires. So now we have a motor, but does it deliver the 1 turn per 30 seconds we need? Let's check this out. Not quite. We will need to reduce their rotation speed with some simple gearing. Now have a rotation speed that suits our needs. Let's now work on our clicking timing mechanism. Thank you. will be using cardboard to create 8 simple wheels. Cardboard, because the material is sturdy, cheap enough to make mistakes and experiment, and can be easily cut and adjusted if needed. The plan is to create 2 sets of 4 wheels, one set being made of one bigger wheel that will act as a guide, and 3 little ones that will act as driver for the moving arms we will build later. We will now cut notches on our sets of small wheels that correspond to our required number of clicks and click timing. Let's now build the movable arms that will interact with our smartphone or tablet. If you are interested to know more about interacting with capacitive screen and why this design works without the use of a human hand, feel free to check our series. Let's put all the parts together and do final adjustments. If it looks trivial here, in real life getting everything adjusted took me hours. But the result was worth it. worth it, because when we started experimenting some time ago about capacitive stylus, our goal has always been to build an automated machine. So, it looks like today, we have reached our long-term goal, and become a lot wiser in the meantime. Nice.